Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I am your instructor today. And I will discuss the topic cooling systems. So this topic is taken from STCW Function 1 Marine Engineering at the operational level. Our competence, operations, surveillance, performance, assessment and maintaining safety of propulsion plant and auxiliary machinery. Our QOP, the efficient operation, surveillance, performance, assessment and maintaining safety of propulsion plant and auxiliary machinery. Next, our learning outcome. At the end of this lesson, the student should be able to analyze the problems that may arise in cooling water species of diesel engines. Evaluate the test used in the control of diesel cooling water treatment. Interpret the implications of out-of-limit readings from the water treatment test and state the corrective procedures which should be undertaken. Compare the procedures which may be used to counter contamination of diesel engine cooling water. So we have here the introduction. The machinery systems fitted on board ships are designed to work with maximum efficiency and run for long hours. The most common and maximum energy loss from energy is in the form of heat energy. This loss of heat energy has to be reduced or carried away by a cooling media, such as central cooling water system, to avoid malfunctioning of or breakdown of the machinery. So we have here an illustration. So cooling water problems of marine engines. So we have scaling, corrosion, dirt and dust accumulation, and biological rot. So I will give you an example of scaling. So the result of the scaling process. So as you can see, this is scale. So before the scaling process and after the scaling process. So what is the consequence of these scales or the effect of the result? So if you have scales in here inside, as you can see, this is like a stone which is accumulated here and being hard inside of your what we call the surface of the tube of your cooler. So if this is accumulated scale here is too much in here, or even not too much, the transfer of heat of your from the fresh water to the sea water is reduced. Why? Because you cannot cool down quickly the fresh water from your engine cooling water if you have skill inside of your engine. But here, if you are if there is no skin inside, as you can see, this is very clean. So the transfer of heat from the fresh water to the sea water is very rapidly. So very effectively, very rapidly, and very efficient because there is no skin inside of your tube, cooler tube. So this skin, if you are familiar, if you are drinking coffee in your home, you are boiling water. Boiling the water. So in the kettle, as the kettle you use in a many times, there is a build up of scales inside. It looks like a stone inside. So this is a scale. So that is very bad in your cooling system because it is the heat transfer of your cooling water to the other other medium is reduced. So it's not efficient anymore. Corrosion. So you have here corrosion. So as you can see here, the effect of corrosion here, as you can see, your exhaust valve seat is very corroded. So this is already damaged and you cannot use. So if this is very corroded and your cooling water is leaking and your exhaust is leaking to your cooling water, and your engine will overheat because your the pressure of your cooling water is what we call fluctuating. So I experienced that before. So here you are, this is also corroded. So the seat of your liner here is damaged. So the combustion gas will leak to your cooling water. So it is very bad. Dirt and dust accumulation. So if you have a dirt and dust accumulation here, it is a problem to your cooling water, to your marine engines. You have also biological rot. So if your so this is easy to heat exchangers, oil coolers, evaporators, fire pumps, and ancillary system. So power in, you have seawater cooling line, main switches valve, and your Catalco anodes, you have switches, inlet valve. So this is anodes. So it's aluminum anodes, and we have here the copper anodes. So this will what we call the kill the biological growth, which is supposedly if there is no current here, this is anode, this is current here, so from power supply, so to kill the biological growth. So if this is alive, so I experienced this before because system there for killing the biological growth is chemical, injecting the chemical, but the time the chemical system there, the equipment is not working anymore, the chemical is not penetrating to the switches, so there are a lot of, so I found a lot of biological growth inside the switches as well as the pipe going to the generator. So it is almost blocked. So the pipe is 6 inches inside the meter, but the pipes are almost already 2 inches inside the meter because of the biological growth inside the pipe. So there are a lot. So we call in Bisaya, it is called CC, and shield, in English shield. So a lot of shield inside the pipe. So the 6 inches pipe becomes the 2 inches pipe because of the biological growth inside the pipe. So this is very important. So we have also here the critical parameter for the engine cooling water. So we check the conductivity and the total dissolved solids, the TDS. We check also the pH, and we check the alkalinity, the hardness, and the saturation index. So we have here the example. So we have here water hardness. So grains per gallons. So acceptable is, so the parameter is 4.7 to 5.8. So inside, it should be inside here. So for example here, greater than 11.7. So it is poor quality, poor hardness. So unacceptable is greater than 29.2. So already red, as you can see here. So this hardness of water is a lot. So a lot of hardness contamination. TDS, total dissolved solid. So we have ideal is 0 to 170 ppm, which is parts per million, and the recommended is less than 500 parts per million, and acceptable is greater than 1000 ppm. So this is salt content. So that is a example. So we have also here the alkalinity and the acidity. So pH is acidity, and you have also alkalinity. So here, as you can see, in the graph, so we have here relative corrosion rate. So from 0 to 6 is acidic, so your water is acidic, so you cannot use that water to your cooling water because your engine will be damaged due to corrosion as the result of the acid. So we have also here the alkalinity, so alkaline. So remember, 0 to 6 is acidic and 6 to 14 is alkaline, so alkalinity. So the stable, so acidic film here, 0 to 6, so you cannot use this water to your cooling water, So from 6 to 12 is stable film. But normally your alkalinity is usually between 8.5 to 11.5. Normally, so more than that, 12 to 14 is dilute alkaline, so it will cause also so the result of alkaline, it will cause what we call scaling to your, as I said earlier here, scaling. So result of alkaline, but result of lower pH, which is acidic, is corrosion. So this is result of alkalinity, high alkalinity. This is scaling, and result of acidic, which is low pH, is corrosion. So that is the result. So remember that. Remember that keyword. So you should maintain your pH value between 8.5 to 11.5. So to avoid problem of your engine cooling water space. So next we have here the conductivity and total dissolved solids, TDS. So conductivity is a measure of the ability of water to conduct electrical current, and it indicates the amount of the total dissolved solids, so in water. So pure distilled water will have a very low conductivity, low minerals. And seawater will have a high conductivity. So high minerals, dissolved solids present no problem. So we have here the conductivity and total dissolved solids, TDS. Conductivity is a measure of the ability of water to conduct electrical current, and it indicates the amount of the dissolved solids, TDS, in water. Pure distilled water will have a very low conductivity, low minerals, and seawater will have a high conductivity. High minerals. Dissolved solids present no problem with respect to the cooling capacity of water, since the evaporation rate of seawater, which has 30,000 ppm or parts per million total dissolved solids, is only 1% less than that of distilled water. The problem with dissolved solid is that many of the chemical compounds and elements in the water will combine to form high insoluble mineral deposits on the heat transfer surfaces, generally referred to as scale. The scale stubbornly sticks to the surface, gradually builds up, and begins to interfere with pipe drainage, heat transfer, and water pressure. The primary maintenance objective in most circulating water systems is to minimize the formation of scale. Deposits and conductivity can be used as the controlling value after the TDS, connectivity relationship is between. So this instrument is used to check the conductivity of water and total dissolved solid. So I was using this one when I was working in cruise ship. So the fresh water production there is being checked, especially the seawater is converted to fresh water by the use of reverse osmosis. So we check always the conductivity. So this one. So remember that the problem with dissolved solid is that many of the chemical compounds and elements in the water will combine to form high insoluble minerals because in the heat transfer surface generally referred to as scale. So it can produce scale. So the scale is known as textura. So we have to test always the conductivity. So what causes corrosion? Corrosion is a three-step electrochemical reaction in which free oxygen in the water passes into a metal surface. In one point, referred to as the cathode, and it reacts with the water and electrons. So which have been liberated by the oxidation of metal at the anode portion of the reaction of another spot on the metal surface. The combination of free electrons, oxygen, and water forms hydroxide ions. The hydroxide ions then combine with the metal ions, which were liberated at the anode as part of the oxidation reaction to form an insoluble metal hydroxide. The result of this activity is the loss of metal and open the formation of a deposit. So it will result corrosion to metal. So we have here corrosion problems. So common problems arising from corrosion are reduction of heat transfer and water flow resulting from a partial or complete blockage of pipes. So valves, strainers, etc. Also excessive wear of moving parts such as pump, shaft, impeller, and mechanical seal, etc. So may resist the movement of the equipment. Hence, thermal and energy performance of heat exchange may degrade. So we have here the cooling water before adding corrosion inhibitor should be checked and treated to satisfy following requirements. So we have pH, so between 7 to 9 or 7 to 9, 7, 8 and 9, 7.5, 8, 8.5, 9. So that is a normal value. So sometimes below 7, because this is 7 to 9 is stable, so stable alkaline alkalinity. So total hardness as maximum of 75 parts per million or in milligram per liter. So 75. So we have chloride maximum 50 ppm parts per million or milligram per liter. Sulfate, we have maximum of 100 ppm or milligrams per liter. Silicate maximum 150 parts per million or milligram per liter. Residue after evaporation maximum of 400 ppm. So beyond or below this value and beyond this value will cause a corrosion problems to your what we call the corrosion problem corrosion problem to your to the metal. So it should be within this limit. Next. So some recommended products are listed as follows. So this is to treat the cooling water. We have here the manufacturer, Cibron, Dromarin, Droameroid, or Dromarin. We have Becom, we have Unitor Chemicals, we have Non-Plate Marine Chemicals. So brand name, we have Habuline, Jute Insi, Liquid Jute, MaxiGuard, CWT Diesel, Diesel Guard NB, we have 9-108, 9-131C. So we have constituent, carboxylates, we have nitrate, borate, and nitrate polymer. So delivery form, we have liquid, powder, product, liquid, powder, liquid, and liquid. So minimum dosage for the Cibron. So this is to treat the cooling water, no? So 50 liter per 1000 liter of water. So 50 liter, so that means 2 container. So in every 1000 liter of water. So 3.2 kilogram the powder in every, so for this chemical. Manufacturer, so 3.2 kilogram per 1000 liters. So liquid, 8 liters per 1000 liters. We have also 16 liter per 1000 liters for the Becom, 12 liters per 1000 liter. Unitor chemical, 3 kilogram per 1000 liter, non-plate. Torisimal, 2.5 liter per 1000 liter. So for this one, 8 liter per 1000. So these are the chemicals for treatment cooling water. Checking the cooling water and the system. So if the test result shows that the contents of the cooling water changes suddenly or gradually, so the cooling water system should be checked to trace the cause. Some of the changes may indicate the cause as follows. So chloride content increasing, check the possibility of seawater penetrating into the cooling system, of course. So if the seawater is penetrated into the cooling system, so high chloride content. Check the system which includes seawater, for example, fresh water cooled by seawater. So the seawater is penetrated to the fresh water. So we have here pH value, decreasing or sulfate content increasing. So check if cooling water is contaminated by exhaust gas, check cylinder heat by hydraulic pressure test. So this is the what we call the result of the corrosion. So lower pH value. So lower pH value is acidic. So next, we have also here the treatment and periodical checks of the cooling water. So when distilled water from a fresh water generator, it is used as the engine coolant. So it is highly important to focus on the cooling water treatment to avoid corrosion. The reason is the aggressive nature of the distilled water. If it is not treated correctly, rust will quickly occur, and once the process is started, it will happen fast in a high temperature cooling water. So we have here the recommended specification for engine cooling water. Water type, fresh water, foreign matter, so treated cooling. Typical value and property. Water for filling and refilling without additive. Stability water with additive. So we have here total hardness is not less than 10 degrees. I forgot the meaning. This DH, this I think German. So pH value is 6.5 to 8 at 20 degrees. Chloride ion content is not less than 50 milligram per liter. So for the water for filling and refilling without additive. So this is without additive. But here, with additive, circulation water. So we have not less than 10 degrees DGH. not greater than 7.5 at 20 degrees and not less than 50 milligram per liter. So that is the parameter. So treatment methods. So most corrosion control strategies involve coating the metal with 10 films to prevent free oxygen and water from coming into close contact with the metal surface. So we remove the oxygen. So this breaks the reaction seal and reduces the corrosion rates. So several major chemical treatment methods can be used to minimize corrosion problems and to assure efficient and reliable operation of cooling water systems. So we have here types of corrosion inhibitors. In general, there are four types of inhibitors. So anodic, cathodic, mix, and adsorption. So anodic inhibitors here and cathodic inhibitors here. So you have a lot of symbol, chemical symbol here. So anode, you have anode and steel, and you have cathode. So this is an illustration of this corrosion inhibition. So we have also common adapted in cooling water treatment. In addition, passivation technique is used for galvanized components. Working principles of common corrosion inhibitors is described. So we cannot play this video because of the I already see this one in a slideshow. So anodic inhibitor. So applying anodic inhibitor enables to protective oxide. The inhibitor fail to cover the anodic corrosion points inside the cooling water circulation system. So this method is effectively only if all points are film and isolated from corrosion. So these are anodic inhibitors and cathodic inhibitors. Otherwise, several localized corrosion may occur at the points without effective protection by protective film. Therefore, sufficient safety margin shall be applied, and this shall generally be applied at high dosage levels, so hundreds of milligram per liter. So common anodic inhibitors are chromates, nitrates, orthophosphates, and silicates. Cathodic inhibitor. So, cathodic inhibitor is effective by the formation of protective inhibitor film at cathodic corrosion sites so as to prevent oxygen reduction. So, we remove oxygen in the cooling water. So, it is more effective than anodic inhibitor and lower dosage levels required. Therefore, it is commonly used in cooling water treatment. So, common cathodic inhibitors are bicarbonates, metal cations, and polyphosphates. So other chemicals. We have also mix inhibitor. Mix inhibitor composes of two or three types of inhibitor, and majority of the proprietary corrosion inhibitor formula falls into this category, since chemicals with different characteristics supplement their deficiency with each other. So efficacy of the mix inhibitor increases. Hence, dosage concentration can be significantly reduced, thus lowering the operating cost and environmental impact caused by chemicals. So adsorption, protective adsorb film is formed over the entire metal surface if adsorption inhibitor is used. So the film helps to protect electrochemical reaction between metal and aqueous ions. Some of the organic compounds are suitable to act as absorption inhibitors. So there should be a coating in the metal. We have also passivation. So in order to prevent corrosion on galvanized steel cooling towers and steel pipes, So formation of non porous surface layer of zinc carbonate is one of the effective so methods of the formation of zinc carbonate layer is called passivation. So which is accomplished by controlling pH. So you have to lower, you have to maintain the pH in the normal value. So during initial operation of the cooling tower, control of the cooling water pH in the range of 7 to 8. So this it should be for 45 to 60 days, usually allows passivation of galvanized surface to occur. So in addition to pH control, operation and moderate hardness levels of 100 to 300 ppm as what we call a hardness level. So an alkalinity levels of 100 to 3000 ppm as so alkalinity levels will promote passivation. So for the recap, we have discussed the following, the problems that may arise in cooling water space of diesel engine, species of diesel engines, the ratios and the control of the diesel engine cooling water treatment, and how to interpret the implications of out of limit readings from water treatment test, and state the corrective procedures which should be undertaken. The procedures which may be used to counter the contamination of the diesel engine cooling water. So what to do next meeting, our activity for the next meeting. So we will have a short quiz for the given discussion, and we will have also a random oral recitation, and then after that we will discuss the following. So define pH and explain how it is measured and controlled. So we'll evaluate the test used in the control of the boiler and feed water treatment. So we'll also interpret the implications of out of limit readings from water treatment test, and state the corrective procedures which should be undertaken. So I will end up this video now, this discussion now. Please click like and share. Please write a comment, and please don't forget to subscribe. Please also click notification button so that you will be updated on my next video. So please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching, and see you on my next video. Thank you.